Thank each and every one of you for what we are doing to protect our most vulnerable while we celebrate this very, very special but challenging holiday season.
Ontario Finance Minister Rod Phillips posted this on Christmas Eve, but it turns out by then he was long gone. His office confirmed Phillips left the country on December 13th. Now Phillips is admitting he's been on the Caribbean island of St. Barts. In a statement, Phillips calls it a previously planned personal trip outside the country. He goes on to say had he been aware then of the eventual December 26 province-wide shutdown, we would have canceled the trip. Long before December 26th, the province has been telling people to stay home as much as possible, a message Ontario Premier Doug Ford reinforced while Phillips was away.
Every time you take a trip, it puts people in jeopardy.
On December 15th, while Phillips was abroad, he tweeted photos of himself visiting local businesses, though it was clear they were taken days earlier. Days later, another tweet celebrated Maple Syrup Day by announcing Phillips had picked some up at a local business. Constituents in his riding aren't pleased.
These people are telling people to lock down, but they themselves do not follow their own rules.
It's unfair. Why is it unfair? Because everybody else is doing what they're supposed to do. It's part of the community.
Opposition parties have been quick to channel public anger.
It sends the wrong message, and the minister should be held accountable, and I think that the premier has a responsibility in figuring out what that looks like.
In a statement today, the premier said he was extremely disappointed in Minister Phillips, that Phillips's travel is completely unacceptable, and he's needed back in the country immediately. When Phillips does return, he and his government will face tough questions about how he actually spent his holidays.
I do want to address the situation with the finance minister. Did have a conversation with him. He is on his way back, should be back tomorrow. I can tell you I'm very upset. I'm very frustrated with the situation. I stand out here every single day and tell people to stay at home. People are losing their businesses. We're locking things down. And it's unacceptable that anyone, any elected official, myself included, or anyone that gets up, ignores the rules, and goes down to an island. It's unacceptable, and we're going to have a very tough conversation when he gets back. But I can tell you there can't be rules for elected people and non-elected people. Everyone's in this together, and we're going to stick together, and we're going to get through this, and there's absolutely no excuses.
When did you know he was out of the country?
Yeah, I want to tell you, Jamie, that was a good question. He never told anyone he was leaving, never told me he was leaving. I did call him shortly after he arrived, and I talked to him and asked where he was. He said he was away, so this is going to be an issue. My mistake, and I take full responsibility. At that time, I should have said, get your backside back into Ontario, and I didn't do that. I did talk to him the other day and said, get back here in Ontario as soon as possible. So we'll be talking with him tomorrow when he arrives.
There's a level of deception also with this trip, because he had pre-recorded messages that he had released on Twitter, and and he also had a backdrop when he did an interview with Roger and Durham.
Yeah, no, again, Jamie, this is unacceptable. You know, we're supposed to be the leaders. We can't have a rule for one group of people and then, snub the rule and go do something else. I'm concerned about the videos as well on social media. But we'll address it. I can guarantee the people of Ontario, we're going to have a tough conversation when he gets back.